We must need to proceed to our newest lesson for today, which is matter. So, what is matter? Actually, pag-aralan na natin to simula nung tayo elementary pa lamang. But, kailangan muna natin balikan, no? Balikan natin yung mismong definition ng matter, no? Kung sakali man hindi na natin naaalala, edi kapag ni-recall natin, mas maaalala natin ang definition niya, di ba? And then, what is matter? Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Then usually, so lahat na nakita nating bagay sa ating paligid ay isang example ng matter. That because nakita natin that it is occupies space and has a mass or yung bigat. Diba? So, what are the three states of matter? So basically, we have the three states of matter. They are solid, liquid, and gas. But in some textbooks, meron pa tayong isa pang states of matter, which is yung plasma. And then, according to the higher level in science, specifically in chemistry and physics, meron tayong iba-iba pang exotic states of matter. Pero hindi mo na natin yun na-explain kasi masyado na yung malalim. In matter, meron tayong iba't ibang ibig sabihin ng matter. Meron tayong tinatawag na changes of matter and then yung properties of matter. Mapunta man na tayo sa changes of matter. Meron tayong dalawang examples ng changes in matter or dalawang types ng changes in matter. So, unahin muna natin yung physical change, which involves the conversion of a substance from one state of matter to another without changing its chemical composition. Walang or hindi involved dito ang chemical reaction. Hindi involved ang chemical reaction kung wala ang chemical composition. Makikita natin mamaya example, but we must need to define what is chemical changes. So, chemical change involves the conversion of two or more elements to a chemical compound, often called a chemical reaction. Kung sa physical, hindi kasama ang chemical compositions, sa chemical changes, obviously, kasama dito yung chemical composition. At kung may involve ang chemical composition, kailangan natin i-apply yung tinatawag na chemical reaction. So, makikita natin dito sa next slide, no? Ito yung example na physical changes, no? Which are melting ice, shredding paper, mixing gray and green marbles, and chopping wood, di ba? And then, in chemical changes, no? So, for example, they are burning wood, rotting banana, fireworks, and mixing vinegar and baking soda. Ganun lang kasimple. So, next slide, we must need to talk a little about the properties of matter. Diba? So, meron tayong two types ng properties of matter. Unahin muna natin yung physical properties. So, meron tayong dalawang uri ng physical properties. Unahin muna natin isang question dito na, does the properties depend on amount of substance? If it is yes, it is an example of extensive physical property. Example for that is mass, volume, length, and then shape. Yun yung isang example ng extensive physical property. So, what about kung hindi naman siya or hindi naman sila dumidepende sa amount of substance? So, pwede tayong mag-base sa intensive physical property or intensive property. No, unahin natin yung color, melting point, boiling point, and then yung density. Ayan yung isang example ng intensive physical property. So, what about the next type of properties of matter, which is chemical properties? So, ano yung mga chemical properties na to? Number one, or bullet number one, it is flammability. Next is rusting, burning, corrosion, and reactivity. So, yun yung mga ilan sa mga examples ng chemical properties. But, we must need to understand at this point na mas marami pang examples ng chemical properties, but limited to the following lamang. So, meron ditong isang seat where kung trip mo sagutan, okay, sige, maglalagay ako ng timer dyan. Or else, kung trip mo, i-post mo na itong video na to, then sagutan mo, sundin mo lang ang instruction. So, anong instruction? Identify the following as physical or chemical changes. Within 10 seconds, you can now start answering. So, ayan, yung mga answers ng mismong examples ng physical and chemical changes. Okay, so we must now proceed to the classifications of matter. We have two types of classifications of matter, which are the pure substances and then mixture. They can separate through physical changes, di ba? And then, nakikita natin yung meaning ng pure substances, which cannot be broken down into simpler substances by physical means. Hindi talaga siya na-separate into a physical means or something that it takes chemical reactions and processes to do this. So, makikita natin yung isang example ng pure substances, no? They can be broken down from a complex material or complex substance to a simpler substance, di ba? From complex, nabe-breakdown mo or yun nga, nabe-breakdown mo into a simpler means or simple substances. So, isang example nito, to separate water or the chemical formula of water is H2O, no, into hydrogen and oxygen. You will need to apply electric current to water, which is also known the process of electrolysis. Kung nakikita niyo yung image ng electrolysis, ganyan yung nangyayari. Then at the same time, yung water, it is a compound, di ba? From a compound, nag-breakdown siya into a simple substances. So ano yung simple substances dyan? So, ang simple substances dyan ay yung hydrogen and then oxygen. What about the complex material or the complex medium? So, the complex material based on the example is the water. So, ang complex ay yung water. And then, yung mga simpler substance ay yung tinatawag natin na hydrogen and then oxygen. Nag-disintegrate sila. Not disintegrate into physical means, but in a chemical means. Isang example ng pure substance, no, katulad sinabi ko kanina, when paper burns, it produces carbon dioxide gas and then water vapor from a paper. And then, through the fire, it can produce a carbon dioxide or CO2 and then yung water vapor. Water vapor, we also considered it as a chemical formula of H2O din. Makita natin, di ba? Na nag-breakdown siya into a simpler substances. So, ito na nga yun. Kung ano yung ibig sabihin ng elements at saka compounds. Elements and compounds are one of the examples of pure substances, di ba? Or one of the types, di ba? And then, in elements, no? It contains only one kind of atom. So, helium is one of the example of elements. Kasi nag-iisa lang siya. What about in oxygen? Okay, so i-reason out ng iba dyan. Sir, bakit nakikita natin dito dalawa yung oxygen dyan? So dapat, ano yan? Dapat compound yan, sir. Actually, it is wrong kung sasabihin natin na compound yung oxygen gas na yan. Actually, yung O2, no? Yung 2 na subscript dyan, it signifies kung ilan yung oxygen atoms na nakikita nyo sa mismong image na yan, which is yung letter O. Diba? Yung letter O na kulay orange ang bilog. Isang example yan ng diatomic element. Diba? Kapag sinabi na diatomic element, it composed of one set of atom or an element that composed of two samples of an atom. Naintindihan? Okay. So, what about in compounds? Diba? In compounds, they contains two or more kinds of atom. Isang example dyan na yung dalawang hydrogen and then yung isang oxygen, which kapag pinagmix natin yan, it composed of a water. Bakit naging compound yan? Two or more kind of atoms. So, alin yung two kind of atoms na nakikita natin sa water? So, dalawang hydrogen and then isang element or isang atom ng oxygen. One set of hydrogen which composed of two atoms of hydrogen and then one oxygen atom. Okay, so naintindihan na ang elements and then compounds. Nakita naman natin ng malinaw at maliwanag. And then next, in elements, all matter can be broken down chemically into about 100 different elements. Actually, hindi lang 100 eh. Mga nasa mahigit 120 something plus na. Ganun na kadami ang mga natutuklasin ng elements even until now. Actually, gusto ko man itong ikwento kaso masyadong haba yung discussion natin. But in elements, no, yung kung sino man yung nag-formulate nito, actually nag-formulate nito si Mendeleev at saka si Mayer, 'di ba? Actually may history itong dalawang 'to na hindi kayo maniniwala, pero hindi ko muna ikukwento yung history nila kasi baka may spoil kayo, no. So, according sa kanila,
noong mga time na na-formulate nila yung periodic table of elements, nag-leave sila ng mga blank spaces or blank boxes dyan in order to prove na someday, na kapag nawala na din sila, may mga chemist or physicist na makakatuklas ng mga elements, and then at the same time, pwede nilang ilagay din dito sa periodic table of an elements kung ano man yung mga natuklasan nila mga elemento. Actually, madadagdagan at madadagdagan pa yan. Kasi kung yung mga natutuklasan natin mga elements ngayon is kulang pa. Sobrang dami pa mga dapat pang tuklasin. And then, all discovered elements must be found in the periodic table of elements. Doon lang talaga. Diba? Then, in naming of an elements, no? They came from a Greek, Latin, or German words that describe some of their properties. Example is the gold. Gold is an example of element. Then, the Latin word is aurum. And then, the meaning of aurum, which means shining dawn. The next, in lead, the Latin word, which is plumbum, meaning heavy. And then, while in iodine, in Greek word, it is iodes. And then, it means violet. And then, in chlorine, it comes from the Greek word chloros, which means greenish yellow. And then, lastly, bromine, which came from the Greek word bromos, which means stench. Ayan. And some names came from the places where they were first discovered, such as the naturally occurring francium, germanium, polonium, and artificially made elements like americium and californium. So may mga elements na binabase sa lugar kusan sila natuklasan. Then, there are also some elements named after famous scientists such as a curium, einsteinium, mendelevium, and nobelium. Minsan, nadidiskubre yung mga elements at pinapangalan base sa kung sino man yung mga scientists na nakatuklas nun. And then, furthermore, some element symbols are obtained from their original or Latin, Greek, or German foreign names such as antimony. So, ang symbol niya is Sb for stibium. Copper, element symbol, which is Cu for caprum or cuprum. Gold, yung symbol niya ay Au for aurum. Iron, symbol niya is Fe for ferrum. Lead or Pb for plumbum. And then tungsten, and yung symbol niya is W for wolfram. How to write an element easier? Abbreviations are used to make writing elements easier. These symbols are either one or two letters that come from the element's name. Examples are helium. So, yung first letter is always uppercase. Mas malaki dapat. And then, yung second letter is always lowercase. First letter lang dapat ang may pinakamalaki. Kasi may mga times kasi na kapag gumawa tayo ng chemical formulas through combination of some chemical symbols, minsan napapaghinala kapag mali-mali yung sulat natin na paghihinalaan na magkakasama, no? Magkakasama yung mismong element, no? Magkakasama yung mismong compound at napapagkamala natin kadalasan na isang element. So, kung nakita nyo man yung example dyan, ayun yun, di ba? Mali yan. Kung ano yung nakikita natin dyan, which is ayun yung tama. Okay? So, how about metals, non-metals, and then metalloids? So, ayan, nakita na natin. No? So, yung mga nakulay pula dyan, yan yung example ng mga metals. And then, yung mga kulay yellow, they are metalloids. Diba? So, ano yung ibig sabihin ng metalloids? No? So, yung metalloids, they are both exhibits, no? They are both exhibits the properties of metal and non-metal elements. So, how about yung mga kulay blue? So, yung mga kulay blue, yan yung mga non-metals. So, mamaya malalaman natin yung mga distinctive properties ng mga metals and non-metals. Also, with metalloids, how about noble gases? Noble gases, matutunghayan din natin siya later on. Noon na nakikita natin siya sa pinaka edge or sa may mismong right part ng ating screen. Ayan, nakikita natin. From helium down to radon. Okay, alamin natin, no? Ipasitwer ko ulit si Mayor. Determine the following elements if it is under metals, non-metals, metalloids, or noble gases. So, ayan, I'll give you 10 seconds to answer that. ayan na, nakita natin yung kung ano man yung distinctive elements nila, if it is under metal, non-metal, metalloids, or noble gases. We must need to determine the classifications of elements. So, unahin muna natin yung metal, no? In metal, no, they're good conductor of heat and electricity. Try mong maglagay ng kaldero sa kalan, then hawakan mo yung kaldero, ewan ko na lang, di ka pa mapaso. It is only proved our kaldero is an example of metal which exhibits the good conductor of heat. And also, electricity na rin, no? Try mo yung mga copper wires. The next, malleable. Malleable are hammered into tin sheets. So, kung nakikita nyo sa image, no? From a gold, no? Which is the most malleable metal, they can possibly hammered into a tin sheets. Nakikita natin. And the next, ductile. Ductile are drawn into long and thin wires, just like mga copper wires. And then, kung nakikita man natin, nung tayo'y bata, paminsan, binabalatan natin yung kawad ng kuryente na putol na. Syempre, alam nga naman, putulin mo yung kawad ng kuryente na nandun pa. And then, next. And then, lustrous. They can appear shiny. Katulad ng mga ginto na nakikita nyo dyan. So, natapos na tayo sa mga metal, no? Sa mga classifications of element towards the metal elements. Next is the non-metal elements. So, kung ano yung nakikita natin dito sa graphic organizer na to, regarding to non-metal. Kung ano yung nakikita natin sa metal, no, kabaligtaran lang din siya na non-metals. So, they are poor conductor of heat, non-malleable, not ductile, and not lustrous. Kabaligtaran lang din siya. Then, yung metalloids, katulad ng sinabi ko kanina, they both exhibit the characteristics and properties of metals and non-metals. Yan. Kung ano yung nakikita natin na kulay dilaw dun kanina sa table of, or sa periodic table of elements. So, what about noble gases? So, ito yung classification yan. They are odorless, colorless, monatomic gases with very low chemical reactivity. So, in terms of chemical reactivity, malalaman natin yan sa periodic trends. No, na madidiscuss din natin yan sooner or later on. Then next, in compound, compounds are the substance with a distinct composition of two or more atoms. For a chemical formula, the elements are written down using their symbols, which sometimes contain a subscript. So, ano yung ibig sabihin ng subscript na nakikita natin dyan? Subscripts are a number that is written to the right and below the symbol for the elements. Ayan, nakikita natin, no? Ayan, nakikita natin na yung meron tong subscripts. Not subscripts, no, but subscript. Kasi isa lang yun naman na yung nakikita natin dyan, eh. Base dito, ito sa image na nakita natin dito, which is a chemical formula or yung molecular geometry ng isang water molecule, ayan na, or a compound, no, nakikita natin na dalawa yung hydrogen dyan, di ba? And then nag-iisa lang yung oxygen. So, ilan yung hydrogen? Obviously, edi dalawa, ilalagay natin dito sa may mismong right and below the side of a symbol of letter H, which is yung H, yan yung hydrogen. Then, since iisa lang naman ng oxygen, it is already considered as, huwag na natin ilagay yung 1. Already considered na nag-iisa na siya dyan. Okay na yan. It is already considered as 1 subscript lamang. Kapag 1 subscript lang, huwag na natin lagyan ng 1 dyan as a subscript. Please, automatic na yon. Then, marami tayong example ng compounds, di ba? 2 types of compounds. So, unahin muna natin ang inorganic compounds. It is typically a chemical compound that lacks carbon and hydrogen bond. Yun na yung palatandaan. Lack of carbon and hydrogen bonds. That is a compound that is not an organic compound. Then, a great many inorganic compounds do contain hydrogen atoms, such as water. Water is an example of inorganic compounds. And then, HCl or hydrochloric acid produced by your stomach. Which is yung HCl is an example of inorganic compounds. Bakit? Kasi wala naman silang relationship between the carbon dyan, eh. Diba? Baka sabihin nyo yung letter C, carbon din to. No. Kasi, ayan, no, nakikita naman natin na L yan, eh. Alien, HCl. Yung Cl, it stands for chlorine. And then yung H, yan yung hydrogen. Naintindihan? Okay. And then in the organic compound, no, they are the chemical compound that contains a carbon and hydrogen bond. Mayroong bonding na nagaganap sa pamamagitan ng carbon and then hydrogen. 'Di ba? Kasi minsan kasi sa pagkaka-define kasi natin sa organic compounds, basta mayroong carbon, automatic organic compound na 'yan. No, huwag natin isipin 'yon. Dapat may relationship sila together with the hydrogen together with each other. Carbon and then hydrogen bonding. Dapat sila 'yon. Kapag may bonding sila together with each other, so it is already considered as an organic compound. 'Yan is one of the examples, no. Any of a large class of chemical compounds in which one or more atoms of carbon are covalently linked to atoms of other elements, most commonly hydrogen, oxygen, no, and then nitrogen. And then one of the example of organic compounds is CH4. So ano yung ibig sabihin ni CH4? They are methane. And then C4H10, it is an example of butane. Nakita naman natin dito, meron silang bonding relationship together with the carbon and then hydrogen. Ayan. In the proper writing of chemical formula, number one, write all the atoms present in the compound using the element symbol. Note the number of atoms of each element present in the compound using the subscript. You should write this to the right of and below the element symbol. Ayan. Katulad na sabi ko kanina, doon sa H2O, nandun siya sa right of and below the element symbol. When there is only one atom of that element is present, you should omit writing the subscript number 1. Matik na yun. Kapag one atom lang, sabi na one atom of oxygen, lalo maglalagay pa ba tayo ng 1 doon, hindi na po kailangan. Tanggalin na po natin. Kapag may nakita na tayong isang element lang na nandoon and then walang 1, tama lang din yun. That because it represents as a one atom. One atom of oxygen, no? In a water, one atom of oxygen, 2 atom of hydrogen. Ayan. Actually, baliktad. Two atoms of hydrogen and then one atom for oxygen. Ayan. Nilino ko lang ulit. And then next, number 4, subscripts should not have fractions or number with decimal places. Huwag natin nilalagay yun kasi mababiolate natin yung rule in proper writing of chemical formula. You should only write this as whole numbers. Ano ba pag sinabi natin whole numbers? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so forth, di ba? Okay, in the next number 5, combine all this to form the chemical formula to the given compound. So, nakikita nyo naman kanina sa example. Actually, gusto ko nang din ipakita ulit. Ayan yung isang example ng given compound, di ba? Yun yung example nun. Then next, you should write the elements in a chemical formula in the exact order that they are presented. So, kung ano man yung nakita nyo dyan, based dun sa name ng isang compound or yung chemical formula niya, yun yung kailangan nating sundin at kailangan in a presentable way. Kasi minsan, kinakapitalize nilang natin lahat. Huwag natin ikakapitalize lahat. At tulad na sinabi ko, dapat ang may malaki lamang na letra ay yun yung unang parte ng mismong element. For example, yung helium, yung naging example natin yun kanina. So, yung letter H dun sa HE, yun lang dapat ang malaki. And then the rest, which is yung letter E, dapat maliit lang. Ayan, ganun lang kasimple. So, siguro hanggang dito na lang muna yung ano natin, yung mismong discussion natin towards dun sa classifications of matter. So, kung meron mga questions, ilagay mo lang sa baba, no, i-comment mo lang. And then, kung something na saan ka nako-confuse, pwede natin yung linawi next time. Diba? And then, next topic natin is all about mixtures, di ba? So, sa next topic na natin siya, next lesson na natin siya, talakayin. And then, hanggang dito na lang, sige, goodbye.